Hello, and welcome to this presentation where I will be showing you how to install the character pack for 3DS Max. Once you purchase the character pack from Di-O-Matic, you will be able to download a zip file, and if you simply double-click on the zip file or right-click and choose Open with Compressed Folder, you will be able to run the setup application. Simply double-click on the setup file and the installer of the character pack will start. On the first page, simply click Next. You have to read the license agreement and then choose I agree to proceed. Then, you can fill your name information as well as the company name and enter your serial number. Once you enter your serial number, the next button will become available. Click on it and you will be prompted to select which version of 3DS Max you wish to install the character pack for. In our case, we have 3DS Max 2010 32-bit, so we select 3DS Max 2010 32. We click Next, and then we click on Browse to select the folder where 3DS Max is installed. In our case, it is the default folder, which is /program files/autodesk/3ds max 2010, and we click OK. When the folder is correctly indicated, click Next. A window pops up and you can see all the components of the character pack that are being installed, which are all Di-O-Matic plugins for 3DS Max. During the installation process, you will be asked to install ALP server. This is a requirement for all Di-O-Matic tools, so click Next and the ALP server installation will launch. If it is a local authorization, meaning that you simply need to run the program on your own computer and not with coworkers, keep the Install as Server box checked. For more information about ALP server, we invite you to refer to our ALP server webpage on our authorization webpage on the Di-O-Matic website. Click Next, keep all the default values, and click Next again. We can now see that the ALP server installation is completed, so click on Finish and the last character pack installation screen will be displayed. Simply click on Finish again. This concludes the first part of the character pack installation. Now let's start 3DS Max 2010. Once it opens, a window will tell us that the character pack setup will create a menu, so let's click OK. Then, inside of 3DS Max, on the top, we now have a Di-O-Matic menu. We are now prompted with an authorization dialog. You will see that it indicates a machine ID. This is a unique identification code that we use at Di-O-Matic to generate the license for your specific computer. Please note that if you reinstall Windows, format your computer, or upgrade, this machine ID will change and you will need to request a new license. So whenever you want to request a license, click on Register. It will bring you to the authorization request page of the Di-O-Matic website. Here, you will need to fill in the machine ID along with your details. Let's get back to 3DS Max. Click Copy here. This will copy the machine ID. Then go back to the Di-O-Matic authorization form and then paste your machine ID. Fill in your details and click Send Request. You will then be prompted to restart 3DS Max if you want to, but say no for now. Here is what the zip file you'll receive from Di-O-Matic look like. If we open this zip file, we can see that there is a file named license.lic. Simply remove it from the zip, go back to 3DS Max, where we can access any Di-O-Matic plugin, or simply choose the authorization option. Click Choose License File, and then select the license that is saved on the desktop. Click Open, and that's it. License is successfully installed. We now have access to the Di-O-Matic Character Pack plugins inside 3DS Max. This installation procedure is very easy to follow to get all the plugins working inside of 3ds Max. Thank you all for watching this introduction about the character pack installation procedure.